I'm Doug with America's Best Restaurants, and we travel the country coast to coast to find restaurants that you should dine at on a weekly basis. We're in Dayton, Kentucky. We're at Trotta's, one of the best steak and seafood restaurants that you will not only find in the tri-state, but anywhere in this country. And a big reason behind it is this guy right here, Chef James. So Chef James,
how are we doing, folks?
Tell us all about Trotta's.
Trotta's came into origin roughly about 4 years ago. I took over June 5th of 2019, came out from the Bronx. When I took over here, it was steak and seafood, very limited Italian dishes. Being that I'm truly Napolitan Italian, born in Naples, Italy, came to the States when I was six, grew up in the Bronx, in my mother's cucina, which is kitchen, at the age of 6 and a half, learned what the passion's all about from my mother. So the Italian fare that's on here is very deceiving. Truly Napolitan, I have various dishes that you won't find anywhere else around this area. And being that it's authentic, it's truly authentic. Homemade gravy, folks around here call it marinara. We Italians, we like to call it gravy. Homemade meatballs, I've been making that meatball for 55 years. I'd put my balls up against anybody's balls, trust me, all right? We're gonna be looking at three items tonight. One of three of my most popular. One is a Chilean sea bass, caught fresh, flown into me every Thursday, minimum of 12 pounds, hand cut into 8 ounce portions. You will see the finished product here shortly. Also, a 12-ounce hand-cut ribeye USDA prime. Also, hand-cut USDA prime 8-ounce filet, which will be cooked to mid-rare, roughly about 110 to 115 internal temperature on an open char grill. The nostalgia behind me, this was the only bank, and there is no bank anymore in Dayton, Kentucky. We turned this into a restaurant. The vault room that used to hold the cash is now a private seating area for 2 to 4 people. The safety security deposit box area is still there. It's now our bar area. I went through every safety security deposit box, didn't find a penny, didn't find a gem. But the food that comes out of my kitchen, I can guarantee you this, my heart is on every plate. My mother told me to do that when I was 6 and a half, so trust me, no plate goes in front of you unless my heart is truly on that plate.
This guy has me sold. I tell you what, you're watching this, it's a food show. Chef James, I want to see this man in action. I've heard about him, and it's poetry in motion back in the kitchen. So, you come with us. Let's go inside and check out Trotta's. We're back, we're inside. We said three items. We have three items back with Chef James. So we'll go item 1, 2, and 3. And I wanna say first and foremost, that was an education watching you in the back in the kitchen.
Thank you.
We have been in hundreds of kitchens across the country doing this. And that by far was the most impressive with how you do it. It's almost, I mean, it is all by memory and you nail it. So kudos to you for that.
Thank you, thank you.
No BS. All right, so let's go number one. What are we looking at?
Hi, folks, I'm Chef James. First item up is a 12-ounce hand-cut ribeye, USDA prime, only use prime, wet age for 30 days, homemade seasoning, coast to coast on both sides, goes on an open char grill, not a broiler. Cooked to perfection all the time, every time, always checked with a digital thermometer before that's ever sold to anybody because of the temperatures that we desire according to what the guests wanted to have. Second item up is a Chilean sea bass. Chilean sea bass, fresh caught off the coast of Chile, flown in, receive it every Thursday, 12 pound minimum all the time, hand cut those into 8 ounce portions. Sea bass is very flavorful, flaky, semi-oily fish. The way I get around the oil part of it, I'm gonna go backwards. I'm gonna heat up some extra virgin olive oil so hot to where it starts to smoke. Next stage would be catch on fire. In the meantime, the sea bass is sitting there. I'm gonna put a little cracked black pepper and a little kosher salt on the top. Once I know that oil is at the temperature that I desire, I'm gonna drop that meat side down. I'm gonna get a nice encrusted sear on it. Once I get that, I'm gonna have a cast iron sear plate, nonstick spray on it. I'm gonna flip that fish back on its skin side. It's gonna go in a 550 degree convection oven on the top rack where it's the hottest. About 10 minutes, I'm gonna check it with a digital thermometer. If it's at 140 and above, when I pull that up, the skin's gonna automatically release. Underneath the skin is the fat back, which holds the oils. That fat back goes as well. Then I re-sear the bottom. Once I accomplish that, I'm gonna set it on top of a bed of seasonal greens. I'm gonna dredge a garlic caper butter sauce over the top and then finish it off with a radish microgreen. Beautiful. So at least 10 pounds on a Friday and Saturday, guaranteed all the time. Our next item is an 8-ounce hand-cut USDA prime filet, cooked on the open char grill, the same way we do with the ribeyes. Desired temperature for the guest, always meet that, always check it with a digital thermometer. 5 weeks ago, approximately, we overtook Jeff Ruby as number one steakhouse in the tri-state area, and Mr. Ruby and his business has been around for 40-plus years. We're working on 3.5 years here. I've been here 2.5 years. Number one steakhouse in the tri-state area. Number one in fine dining in Northern Kentucky. A must visit spot, a hidden gem. If you ever read any reviews on us from any local businesses that are talking about places to go and to see, we're always one of the first ones that they mention.
It's melting in your mouth.
Huh? It's gonna melt in your mouth. Always melt in your mouth. Wow. Hand cut USDA prime. It's not going to do anything but taste the very best.
That's, and now when you're saying hand cut, we're in the back. You're not even, there's no measuring, there's this, that. I mean, you know from
I know exactly
where it's at.
Been doing it for a very long time.
And then the overall timing as well, you were saying you can put something on the grill, leave, come back, and it's
it's all repetition, training. Having hindsight, but the passion that you have to have in order for this to be accomplished is pretty much comes from within. And I want to thank my mother, which is above me, for the passion that she instilled in me at the age of 6.5 when I first started growing a passion for this because of her. So we came over from Naples, Italy when I was 6, grew up in the Bronx at 6.5. I was in my mother's kitchen.
I'm gonna keep on eating. Okay, so what's the phrase? You said there was a phrase that she
My mother told me always, never put a plate in front of someone unless if you're willing to put your heart on that plate. And I can guarantee you 99.99% of the time, my heart's on every plate that's going out to the guests from the kitchen.
And you have a fascinating culinary background. Number one, you were in the Marine Corps. Thank you for your service.
Yes.
But you were telling us that even while you were
When I was over in the desert.
You were cooking.
In Afghanistan and Iraq, I would cook on radiators in the barracks at nighttime because it would go down to 30, sometimes 40 degrees from 120 to 130 during the day, drop real quickly at nighttime. But I would put together whatever type of pizza you want to call it, I was making them. So my passion for this started when I was 6.5 to 17, from 17. And for the next 22 years, I served our country as a military police special escort in the Marine Corps. 5 tours over in the sandbox, 3 in Afghanistan, 2 in Iraq.
Thank you for your service.
My pleasure.
And this truly is, this is an art. When you talk about culinary being an art and a science, this guy's got it down. Highly recommend that you make it over to Trotta's. If you live in this area, this is certainly a place you need to be at. If you're visiting the Cincinnati, Northern Kentucky area at any point for a sporting event, concert, you're just coming into town, this is a place that you need to visit. You can find Google, social media, website.
Open table reservation.
Open table.
Open table reservation.
Go on. I recommend that.
Go online to Open Table. You can always get a spot with us. Friday and Saturday is kind of tough. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday is you have an opportunity to be able to do that. Walk-ins, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Friday and Saturday, not so many walk-ins because of how many people we already have on the books. So we try to keep, in order to provide the best service, we try to keep it at a manageable level.
And if somebody wants to eat in the vault, because as we mentioned, this is an old bank, so you can sit in the vault.
In a private
room.
That's
pretty much a reservation. Yeah. You better get on that.
Yeah, that's table 42.
Table 42.
Yeah. It either sits 2 or 4. It was the old cash room, which we made into a private sitting room.
That's awesome. Yeah. Well, hey, they also have a full listing right here on americasbestrestaurants.com. So I've already started to dig in and it's melting in my mouth. So Austin behind the camera is salivating. He was telling me, don't talk too long before we get to this. And I'm dragging it out on purpose just to irritate him. But we're going to wrap this up. You need to come down here, try this. This is ours. So check them out here on americasbestrestaurants.com. All over social media and the website. Get down here, try this.
Sir. Thank you. Appreciate it.
It was a pleasure.
Thank you.
We're digging in. I'm out.